Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the New SAT Math section. This is problem number 23, practice test 4, section 4, calculator allowed. And this is found in the New SAT official study guide. Okay, so the table below gives the distribution of, tables below give the distribution of high temperatures in degrees Fahrenheit for city A and city B over the same 21 days in March. Right, so which of the following is true about the data shown for these 21 days? Right, so we're given temperatures and frequency, right? So we're given temperature for each city and how many days saw these temperatures, particular temperatures, right? So 3 days, for example, here for the first row in city A, 3 days in March had a temperature of 80 degrees, and 14 days, so 79 degrees, etc. And same logic for city B, right? So based on this observation, what's true, right? So let's see. Choice A says the standard deviation of temperatures in city A is larger. So let's think about standard deviation, right? Standard deviation is measuring the spread from the mean, right? So there's a mean temperature value, and it's not 78. Be careful that you know it's not 78 because we have different weights, right? For each temperature, we have different weights, right? That's why we cannot say that the mean is necessarily 78 degrees in each case, right? So let's see. So standard deviation measures the spread, right? The spread from the mean, spread of values from the mean. So in this case, for city A, notice that the majority of the values are at least 78 and above, right? So that they're not too far away from 78 degrees, but we don't know the mean yet. We'll calculate the mean. But this is the initial observation, right? But in this case, for city B, notice that the extreme values away from 78 are the extreme values, right? The extreme temperatures, the 80 and the 76, take on the greatest frequency, which is 6 in both cases, right? So that already should tell you that, oh, you know, it's actually looks like there's a greater standard deviation in this case than here, right? Because everything is so close together to 78. But let's calculate, actually using the calculator, what the mean is for sure in each case, right? So how do you calculate the mean, right? Well, you use the weights for each temperature, right? So you're gonna have you're gonna have 80 times 3 plus 79 plus times 14, right? Because there are 14 days that had 79 degrees in each of them, right? So 80 times 3 plus 79 plus 14, and etc. etc. So when you do it correctly, you should have something like this, right? 3 times 80 plus 14 times 79 plus 2 times 78 plus 77 plus 76. Why is it just 77? Because there was only one day with 77 and one day with 76, right? So I didn't bother to write times 1. But in any case, when you get this sum, right, you divide it by 21 because you have to divide it by the total number of days, which is 21 days, right? 21 days, and well, if you don't know what that means, it's going to be 3 plus 14, 17 plus 2 is 19, plus 1, 20, plus 21, plus 1, 21, right? So 21 days in total in each case for each city, right? Because we're talking about 21 days in March. So when you divide that, your calculator should give you 78.8952381, right? So pretty much like 79, if you round it to the nearest whole number, it's going to be 79 degrees, right? So basically, we're looking at 79 degrees, and guess what? 79 degrees is the midpoint, is the mean, and look at the mean is pretty much taking the greatest number of days, 14 days out of 21, right? So more than half of the number of days takes on the mean temperature value in city A. So that means that we cannot possibly have a substantial standard deviation, right? Because 14 days out of 21 days take on the mean value, pretty much the mean temperature value, right? But let's calculate the mean value, the mean temperature value for city B, using the same logic, right, and the same method. So we're gonna have 80 times 6 plus 79 times 3 plus 78 times 2 plus 77 times 4 and 76 times 6, right? You're gonna add that up and then divide that by the total number of days in March, which is 21, the same thing, right? Because it says over the same 21 days in March for both cities, right? So you have to divide it by 21. If you're unsure that it's 21, add these numbers up, right? It's going to be 6 plus 3, 9, plus 2, 11, plus 4, 15, plus 6, 21, right? So 21 days. So when you do that, you will have something like this. So adding this up and then dividing by 21, the calculator will give you 77.95238095. And that's rounded. You can round it to the nearest whole number. You're going to have 78, right? So you have 78 degrees pretty much as your mean temperature value for city B. Now, guess what? This mean value only takes on 2 days, right? So there were 2 days pretty much that had a mean temperature of 78 degrees. And everything else, and notice that 80 degrees, which is way beyond 78, takes on 6 days, right? And 76, which is exactly 2 degrees below the other extreme value on the other end, also takes 6 days, right? So you have a greater standard deviation here, right? As compared to city A. So that's why answer choice B is the correct answer choice. The standard deviation of temperature city B is larger. All right, answer choice B.